have this excruciating task of possibly botching this whole thing. So, yes, I have about 6 minutes and 40 seconds I've calculated to squeeze in 3,000 years of an architectural idea, which actually has some roots to Winnipeg, believe it or not. So, okay, let's roll. Now, this image here is Winnipeg in 1913. It features Broadway. Broadway is not an avenue. It was because it was initially designed as an ideal town for Winnipeg's elite. It was elm-lined streets with spacious avenues, and here you have the Fort Garry Hotel, and the terminus there is Union Station, which was built by the very same people that built Grand Central. Now, this diagram here is actually the inspiration for Broadway. It was Ebenezer Howard's Garden City movement. This was the idea of having small, planned, greenbelt, healthy environments and master key for overpopulation. And it was all based on this idea of the Garden of Eden. Now, this is a plan that was never conceived. It is a 135 feet wide Memorial Boulevard, which was going to feature monumental architecture, grand vistas, and beautiful City Hall, which was supposed to be at the very end. The inspirers behind this were the same people that actually conceived of this vision here. This was supposed to be our City Hall. It was never finished. It was designed by a Chicago architect named Johnny Acheson. This was a $3 million project, never conceived, and it was supposed to be the terminus between the Manitoba Legislative Building, this beautiful long mall, and this building that was conceived. Now, in the mall, there are only two elements that today you can recognize. One is in the very corner, the cenotaph, which is an obelisk. And at the very end is this grand vision, a reconstruction of Solomon's Temple, which is the Manitoba Ledge. The inspiration to both of those was this. This is a 1901 plan called the McMillan Plan for the redesign of Washington, D.C., where you find the very same thing, a giant obelisk, this beautiful grand mall, terminating in the Capitol building. Now, the beauty behind this was something called the City Beautiful Movement. And the City Beautiful Movement was inspired by this fellow, Emanuel Swedenborg. He was a Christian mystic and had these grand visions of the heavenly Jerusalem. And the heavenly Jerusalem, for Swedenborg, was an urban paradise. It was spacious, it was civic, it was squares, it was park. It was the idea of bringing all of heaven down on earth in the form of architecture and urban renewal. Now, in America, there was another plan to do that, and that is featured here. This is Joseph Smith on the one side, and his plan for the reconstruction of heavenly Jerusalem on the American frontier, known as the City of Zion. Now, the City of Zion has at its very center a Mormon temple, which was understood to be King Solomon's temple. Now, both the City Beautiful Movement and Mormonism have its roots in this order. That is Freemasonry, where they take the principles and allegories of architecture and they ritualize them. And they're part of the most important movement of the Enlightenment, where architecture is lifted to this imperium of the mind. Now, how Freemasons communicate these thoughts are in this variety. These are called tracing boards. And tracing boards show us the elements of classical architecture, pediments, stairs, all set within a garden setting. Now, these are kind of codes for how to impregnate the gardens and cities, which is exactly what happened in this plan. This is the most important architect of the 18th century. This is Claude Nicolas Ledoux's plan for Chartres. And this was an idealized salt mine that would have all of these temples peppered on it. And these temples were to give you virtues and moral instruction, sexuality, and whatnot. Now, Ledoux's plan had a precursor as well, which was this plan. And this is Schweizer Garden in Germany. And as you can see here, you have another very similar plan to the mall, except what's designed here is a garden setting which is peppered with all of these fabriques, and these fabriques are supposed to lead you into moral advancement and civic duty. Now, the origin of Heidelberg is this plan, which is from 1620, which was called the Eighth Wonder of the World, and this is where all of science, all of engineering and architecture come to life in this garden utopia. And this garden utopia was a reflection of the heavenly Jerusalem. Now, the inspiration behind that particular garden was this plan. This plan was Christianopolis, which was devised by Johann Valentin Andrier, who's the father of the Rosicrucians, a secret society that believed in alchemy. And could change the world. Now, the master alchemist of the age was this man. This is Christopher Wren's plan for the rebuilding of London in 1666, where he places at the very center of London St. Paul's Cathedral, which he envisioned as King Solomon's Temple, with these 12 radiating lines that go to these terminus. Now, holy crap. Okay, now the inspiration behind Wren's plan was this particular model. This is El Escorial Palace, a monastery palace in Spain, which was built by King Philip II, who was seen as the second Solomon. And he designed this in such a way that the very center of, forget that, okay, we're moving on. Now, this is the masterwork of the Renaissance. This is called Sforzinda. It's an eight-sided star. People who know my work on the ledge will understand this. And this is a magical utopia and a city that would be a perfect city that would lead to perfect society. The inspiration behind that is this. This is the medieval view of God, the master architect, and fashions creation with a compass. And the master builders of the compass were the Gothic cathedral architects who used King Solomon's temple and the heavenly Jerusalem in the plans of their cathedrals. So, here's where it all ends. This is God's first and only architectural project. This is King Solomon's temple. And it is designed in the form of cities, gardens, legislative buildings, and our very own city. And what reminds me of this particular temple, which was destroyed, is it leads me to this project. This is exactly on the spot where the city hall was supposed to be. And instead of the virtues of enlightenment and order and benevolence and Freemasonry, we have business, the arts, and what is the other thing? And education. Exactly. So there we go.